people who are not American citizens are deciding the outcome of the elections, like we were just talking about. According to data compiled by the Cooperative Congressional Election Study, more than 14% of non-citizens were registered to vote in both 2008 and 2010. Of those, 6.4% actually voted in 2008, and more than 2% in 2010. What's more, those votes were critical in determining the outcomes of some high-stakes races, including the 2008 victory of Minnesota Senator Al Franken over the Republican incumbent Senator Norm Coleman, a race that was decided by just 312 votes. Judge Andrew Napolitano is a Fox News senior judicial analyst, and he is here to break this down. I know people are not going to be stunned to find out that non-citizens vote, although they should be. But the fact that these races may have been decided by non-U.S. citizens is startling.
Yes, and in a state like your home state, where one does not have the image of that happening up there, I don't know where the non-citizens come from. We'll start with a couple of basics, Gretchen. It is against the law in all 50 states and in the District of Columbia, and it's against federal law for non-citizens to vote. So it's unlawful for them to do so.
Okay.
It is also against the law for election officials knowingly to permit non-citizens to vote by looking the other way.
Yeah, but it's pretty easy to get it done if you're a non-citizen, right?
Yes, it is. It is easy to get a driver's license with a photo on the driver's license and show that in the states that require photo IDs. Now, you vote in Connecticut, you have to show an ID. I vote in New Jersey, I don't have to show an ID.
Right, but here are the states where you actually have strict photo ID laws, where voters must show a photo ID in order to vote.
A photo ID that proves citizenship.
Correct. Now, these are strict laws, so we are looking at Georgia, Indiana, Kansas, Mississippi, Tennessee, Virginia, and Texas. However, it gets a little more squishy when you get to the state where I vote in, which is Connecticut.
Right.
Because technically, you don't have to show a driver's license or a photo ID.
What do you show?
I do show it because that's what I have. But according to the law, you don't actually have to show a photo.
All right. If you want to put that map up again, the Supreme Court of the United States construed the Indiana statute and found that that was the paradigm, that was acceptable, that was the one the others need to be modeled after. Texas is a little different. The Supreme Court said it's close enough. The other statutes are all modeled after Indiana. So the Supreme Court of the United States has held as a matter of law twice now that for a state to require a photo ID is not discriminatory and is not unconstitutional. And yet, 43 states don't do it and have very little checks on this. What is the check? Candidates are permitted to have challengers, and challengers are permitted to say, I don't know how they say this, I was never a challenger. Hey, you, I don't think you're a citizen. Prove your citizenship.
Yeah, who are they going to say that to?
Listen, election day, courts are closed. Judges sit all day. I used to volunteer for this assignment. No one ever came into my courtroom challenging a person for being a non-citizen.
Wow.
They challenged them for not living where they claim to live.
Right.
So this could be very dangerous, and it could affect the outcome, and then there could be litigation after the outcome.
Yep, and a lot of close races that we're talking about.
Yes.
Judge, thank you.
You're welcome.
And you know Fox News Channel is America's election headquarters. A week from today, starting at 6 p.m. Eastern, Brett Baer and Megyn Kelly will be covering all the political action. You can also stay connected with foxnews.com for all the latest developments.